Churchill was very hostile to the working classes. There had been a miner strike in which he ordered troops out, and people remembered that. Also, when he was younger, he actually believed that the working classes were an inferior people and advocated sterilizing prison populations and the disabled. So he was an aristocrat to the core. People knew that. And also, you have to remember that he wasn't elected prime minister the first time.
We shall defend our island, whatever the cost may be. We shall fight on the beaches, we shall fight on the landing grounds, we shall fight in the fields and in the streets, we shall fight in the hills. We shall never surrender.
Can you tell me about the Bengal famine of 1943?
To list the different causes of the Bengal famine of 1943, one was inflationary financing, because India was a massive source of resources for Britain's war. It spent about £2 billion on the war, and the government didn't have enough money, so it simply printed money. And the money supply increased by 6 or 7 times, and it went mostly to the armaments manufacturers and other war suppliers, and it sucked the food out of the countryside. Then when the Japanese took over Burma in March 1942, that cut off a major source of imports of rice to India. But Churchill's role in all this is that even though India was short of food, he insisted that India instead export food. So India was exporting 40,000 tons of wheat every year and also exporting rice.
And was this primarily for the war effort?
This was primarily for the war effort, but the United Kingdom had put in place a plan to feed its people as early as 1936. They had stockpiles. They had rationing booklets printed and distributed even before the war broke out. In India, although it was completely clear it would be a major source of supplies for the war effort, there were no stockpiles. And when it became clear that the famine is raging, that people are dropping on the streets of Calcutta, several foreign countries offered aid, including the US and Canada.